Celebrate Him. Amen. He's the author and the finisher of our faith. Amen. And we thank God for Christian ministries. Come on and give God a praise. Amen. We also praise God for our viewing audience that is tuning in with us on today through Facebook Live. We praise God for you. And if you have a particular prayer request, put your prayer request in the chat. And rest assured, Bishop Quinn will go and look at those requests and then individually pray that the Lord will bless in the name of Jesus. And you know, the Bible says that the prayers of the righteous availeth much. The prayers of the righteous availeth much. And God wants us to pray. How many of you know God wants you to pray? He wants you to pray. He wants you to come boldly to the throne of grace that you might obtain mercy and find grace to help in the time of need. And I used to think, the reason why I keep bringing that up, I used to think that that only meant for the righteous to come boldly to the throne. But it doesn't mean that. God wants everybody, amen, to come boldly to the throne. And come boldly means to come with confidence. Come with confidence believing, come with confidence trusting, come with confidence with desiring the help that God is able to provide. God wants to help us. Amen. God wants to strengthen us. That's why he sent Jesus to bless you. Amen. The scripture says he sent Jesus to bless you. Amen. And Jesus' job, his job is to bless you, to heal your broken heart. Amen. To set the captive free. Isn't that beautiful? Amen. We all was bound. Some of us still are bound, but that's okay. But Jesus is able to set us free. Amen. And whom the Son is set free is what? Free indeed. I thank God there's freedom in Jesus. Freedom in our Savior. The Bible describes him as the balm in Gilead. That balm is just referring to he's the ointment. He's anointed. He's anointed to save you. He's anointed to deliver you. He's anointed to help you. Amen? Hallelujah. He's anointed. Somebody say, he's anointed. He's anointed. That's when, amen. He said, he was talking to one guy that lacked faith. He said, Lord, I believe. Then he said, Lord, help my unbelief. Sometimes we believe, and then sometimes we need to push to help us to believe. And if we call on Jesus, he will answer prayer. He'll help our unbelief. So as we get ready to go before the Lord in prayer, as we begin to seek him, as we begin to call on him, if you have a particular prayer request, you can let it be known at this particular time. What is your prayer request? What is your prayer request? Let us remember Evangelist Harrington, his son, Jabeel, her son, Jabeel, that the Lord will bless him. Bless him. Amen. Go ahead and say it. What's your request? Praise the Lord. Amen. Let us remember Sister Priscilla. And then I gotta give her a call. She called me. Brother Avery, you got a request? Yeah, they're raising their hand, they're messing with me. I won't get you. All right, let us remember Brother Leroy and the passing of his aunt. And Brother Dave Douglas. Sister Amanda, won't you stand up if you're gonna make a request? Yes, thank you. Hallelujah. Yes. That's your husband's aunt. His mother. Oh, amen. Let us pray with the Lord. Touch of God. Evangelist Arrington. Brian Arlington. Brian did. Climbing is your brother. Sorry for your loss as well, but Brian and your family were childhood friends growing up. Yes. Oh, that was, I was just thinking about the other days, but God knows. Yes, God knows. God knows. Alright. We want to ask the church to stand. Saints, don't stop praying, for the Lord is nigh. Saints, don't stop praying, He'll hear your cry. For the Lord has promised, and His word is true. Just keep on praying, He'll answer you. Saints, don't stop praying, for the Lord is
Shout out your anointing! Shout out your shout out your power. Lord, you said all that sin come short of the glory of God. I mean, Lord, lift us up by your strength. Lift us up by your power. Lord, turn our hearts around. Turn our mind around. Help us to see you, Lord. Help us to feel you, Lord. Help us to walk in your grace. Walk in your anointing. Walk in your power. In the name of Jesus. And Lord, we pray, Lord, that you bind every evil spirit, every demonic power that would come to hinder. In the name of Jesus. And Lord, we pray that you send forth your mercy, send forth your grace, send forth your strength, send forth your power. In the name of Jesus. Lord, break through any stronghold, break through any bad Lord, break through any high thing that exalts ourselves against the knowledge of God. And Lord, bless us to submit ourselves in the name of Jesus. And we pray, Lord, for traveling nurses, for those that are traveling over the airways and the highways and the byways in the name of Jesus. And now, Lord, we commit this service into your hands. Hallelujah, Lord, we pray, Lord, that you grant your servant and brothers another the praise and worship team and another those that are hearing on today. Lord, we got needs, we've got desires. Lord, we pray, Lord, hallelujah, that you take this word and you feed the multitude. And Lord, feed the multitude. Hallelujah, with as little as much. And Lord, shout in the name of Jesus. Lord, multiply your grace. Multiply your anointing. Multiply your deliverance. Multiply your power. Multiply your glory. Show up in this place like never before. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' precious and mighty name. Hallelujah. As you remain standing, come on, just give the Lord a praise. Come on, just praise him because you received anything out of that prayer. Praise him for what you received. Alright, if you've got an expectation, just praise God for your expectation. Praise God for your reception of your expectation. Praise God that your prayers are answered. Praise God that the door is open. Praise God that the door is trying to open. And God is shut in the name of Jesus. Come on and give us a moment. Praise God for your healing. Praise God for your deliverance. Praise God for your breakthrough. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. It was the Lord that woke you up this morning. It was the Lord's mercy that you are not consumed. Because his compassion, they fail not. They are throughout before. Great is. Somebody say, great is.
A time to kill, a time to heal. A time to break down, a time to build up. A time to cast away stones, a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace, a time to refrain from embracing.
A time to get, and a time to lose, a time to keep, and a time to have
as well. A time to win, a time to sow, a time to keep silent, a time to speak. And let us skip down, all the way down to verse 22 and verse 21. Read.
Who knows the spirit of the man that holds up her? And the spirit of the beast that holds down her.
Read. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading of His Word. Amen. There's a time. And what time is it? It's time to pray for them. It's bad. Later on, it's going to be time to give an offering. Elder Duck used to say, what time is it? They used to say, it's offering time. Oh, it's blessing time. I better let it go while I'm ahead.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord. Lord. Worship come in the sanctuary. Amen. 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 Amen.
Yeah.
Thank you.
get ready to change the order of our service of today. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. God is great. And as we look toward our announcements of today, we want to welcome everybody that's here today and certainly give God praise and glory and honor because he is worthy to be praised. Isn't God worthy? Hallelujah. He's worthy to be praised. And we thank God for how he has blessed us to come together one more time. Aren't you glad? Thank you, Jesus. And we certainly want to wish anybody that is having a birthday, a happy birthday, any birthday people in our midst. Thank you, Lord. Anybody having an anniversary on today? Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Y'all just keep on living. Y'all have some birthdays. Y'all keep on living. Y'all have some anniversaries. Amen. We certainly want to thank God for this. Brother Lee being in our midst, Sister Kathy's brother. Amen. We thank God for yourself. Amen. Praise God. Glad to be here. Glad you're here. Yay, amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Praise God. I think that should be all of our testimony. There's no other place that we'd rather be than in the house of the Lord. Amen. David said that, didn't he? Thank you, Lord. One thing that I have desired of the Lord, and that will I seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life. Amen. So we certainly praise God for that. By way of announcements, we thank God for our open house coming up. Christian Ministries open house is August 14th. Amen. From 12 to 4 p.m. Amen. We will have a panel discussion with chatting with Sergeant. Amen. We'll have various vendors located throughout this great place here, a lot of space in here. And we'll have dinner is served by Lisa Heidelberg. She'll just be doing light refreshments stationed around the building. Amen. So we can fresh ourselves. Amen. So we want you to come out and we invite the public out, invite all those that, that you're connected with to come and see. We're going to be featuring our Achievers Entrepreneurial Hub, which we're in the midst of looking to, y'all pray with me, looking to get grants and grant money to establish the Entrepreneurial Hub. And it's really going to be designed to help those that want to start businesses. And it's going to be housed upstairs, and we have some space set aside for that. That's going to be called the Achievers Entrepreneurial Hub. And it's designed, it's going to be a community of people that are helping each other to succeed in their business. And with that platform, we're going to also be having a series of luncheons once a month to help to keep the vision alive. Amen. How many know you got to keep your vision alive? Yes, you got to keep your vision alive. And also, too, we're establishing our Youth Development Academy. We're going to get funding from that. Craig, we've got a meeting on Wednesday. When do we have a meeting? Wednesday. We've got a meeting on Wednesday at 11 o'clock. Amen. With those that hold the purses to those grants that we're going after. Amen. Money's out there. Why not us? Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. So that's going to be our Youth Development Academy, where we're focused in on those people that are in middle school all the way to high school. And it's basically an advocacy. I was calling it a mentorship program, but I had to change it from a mentorship to advocacy because I'm not doing mentorship training. And if somebody, you know, get in trouble, then they can look at us. So it's an advocacy program that we're establishing for our youth. And last but not least, then, is the going to be featuring our New Horizons Daycare Center. So as you see that we're actually doing and trying to help people from ages 2.5 all the way through adulthood. Amen. Amen. And fits into our vision to be a caring fellowship, leading souls to Christ, strengthening members and families, making disciples, equipping them for service and community ministry. And those of you here at Christian Ministries that want to be a part of this vision, amen, that we're setting and establishing, just come see me. We'll talk about it, and we'll make you a great part of it. Amen. And then also, we're looking to build our congregation, build our praise and our worship, and move forward in the work of salvation and deliverance. So, so those is what's going on August 14th. Amen? Amen. Amen. So we want you to pray. All right, and then here at Christian Ministries, we have our Sunday school, which begins at 9:30 a.m. I want you to come to Sunday school Christian education. Our morning worship is right now at 11 a.m. Our Bible study is Wednesday at 6 p.m. And our Friday night prayer, last two Friday nights we didn't have prayer, but we'll get back on schedule this Friday at 6 p.m. Amen. And our motto is pursuing excellence until excellence is achieved. Amen. So we thank God for each and every one of you, and we praise God for you. It's blessing time. Amen. Tell your neighbor, it's blessing time. Blessing time in the house of God. It's blessing time in the house of God. God loves a cheerful giver. Amen. God loves a cheerful giver. And I instructed my wife to write a check for me. And I'm going to start carrying around some old cash. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Those of you that are like me, I go back and forth. Sometimes I carry cash and sometimes I don't. But those of you that don't have cash, you can go to our Tithe giving site. And then download Tithe on your phone and find Christian Ministries, the Apostolic Faith Church in Kiev. Amen. We thank God for your liberal giving. God loves a cheerful giver. God has desired that we bring in all the tithes and the offerings into the house of the Lord. Amen. 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 So we want to ask the church to stand. Thank you, Jesus. And let every heart pray, O gracious Father, in the precious and the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, we certainly thank you. We praise you, Lord, that you bless us here on today, that we have an opportunity to give, to sow seed into the kingdom. We ask you, Lord, that you bless 30, 60, and 100 fold. We bind every evil spirit of demonic power that would come to hinder in giving. And Lord, we ask you, Lord, that you bless these, thy great servants, as they sow seed into the kingdom. Bless them, Lord, with a double portion of whatever they desire, according to your will. This we pray in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. We turn you over to the hands of our ushers. Turn to the center. And come on now. We thank God for Sister Usher being back in our midst on today. Amen. All the way from Savannah, Georgia. Amen. Thank you. We're just so glad to be here on today. We thank God that He is great. Amen. He's greatly to be praised. I want you just to invite your attention for the next half hour. Amen. To the book of St. John. John chapter 14. And I want the church to stand with me as we get ready to go into the scriptures. Reading out the word of the Lord. It's good to read the Lord, read the word of the Lord. They got the concept of standing in the book of Ezra. In the book of Ezra. And I'm not going to ask you what they did to do what they did. They read the scripture standing in the house of the Lord, knew from day until evening. Amen. Just reading the scriptures of the Lord. So I'm just going to ask you to stand with me just for 30 seconds. And reading the word of the Lord. In the book of St. John, chapter number 1, chapter 14, and verse number 1. Let us read it together. What does it say?
Let
your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go prepare a place for you. I will come again to see you unto myself. And where I am, there you may be also. Let us pray. Gracious Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for this word on today. We ask you, Lord, that you open up our understanding. Give us strength and give us grace. Open, give us the door of heaven. In Jesus' name, amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. And I certainly do want to also read with your hearing St. John 14, verse 27. Jesus says, peace I leave with you. My peace give I unto you. Not as the world give I unto you. So once again he says, let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. And that's the subject that we want to take for today. Let not your heart be troubled. Let not your heart be troubled. Guard against a troubled heart. Guard against a troubled heart. In the process of things, Jesus was preparing his disciples for a change. He was preparing them for a transition. And if we have to be honest with ourselves, we don't like change. We don't like transitions. Only time that we like a change is when the change is for our good. And sometimes it's hard to get us to make changes, even for our good. And in the scriptures here, Jesus was telling his disciples that because he had taught them over 3 years, been with them at this point, showing them miracles, signs, and wonders. And they had become to rely upon him. And they even confessed that he was the Messiah, the one that should reestablish Israel, the king that should reestablish the will and the way of God. They looked at him as the one that should liberate them from the Roman bondage. So Jesus kind of flipped the script on toward the end of his natural life. He told them that it behooved Christ to suffer and to die and to give his life as a ransom. They didn't fully understand the mission of Jesus, that he came as a lamb this time, and then the next time when he comes, he's coming as a king to establish a kingdom. So he came this time to offer up a sacrifice, to be a sacrifice, to be the savior of the world. And when Peter and the group found out that Peter said, be it far from thee, that you should do such things. And Jesus looked at Peter and said, get thee behind me, Satan, because thou desirest not things that be of God. So Jesus here in our subject, in our text, in the previous chapter 13, Jesus is literally having the Last Supper with them. He's literally having his last meal with them as his earthly meal, his communion meal that he was having with them. And then he begins to show them further and talk to them more about his way. And Jesus got up from the table and he begins to wash his disciples' feet. And when he begins to wash his disciples' feet, he tells them that this is what I want you to do. What I've done unto you, I want you to do unto one another. And Jesus, Peter rose up again in Jesus and said, Lord, you will never wash my feet. And Peter told that to Jesus, and Jesus said, if I don't wash your feet, you have no part with me. And then he quickly repented and said, Lord, wash even my hands and my head and my feet. Jesus told him, it's just enough. If you're clean, you're clean. Every whit, you're every bit to clean. So Jesus then begins to talk to them and tell them that this particular dinner, and also that he said, one of you going to betray me. One of you going to turn your back on me. One of you is a backstabber. One of you is going to get me. One of you is going to work with the devil and turn me in. That's what Jesus was telling. He was telling them that one of you going to be getting me. And they all got kind of quiet and began to look around and ask the question, is it I? Is it I? Is it I? Is it I? And then Peter, once again, Peter was always there. Peter said, hey, you John, you the one that's laying your breath, your head upon Jesus' breast. Ask him who it is. Which one? You the one Jesus loves. So ask him. And he began to ask. He said, Lord, which of us is going to betray you? And Jesus said, the one that dipped his bread in my salt, he's the one that's going to betray me. And don't you know, right after that, Judas Iscariot, he dipped the bread in the salt. And Jesus looked him in the eye and says, what thou doest, do it quickly. Go ahead and take care of what you're getting ready to do. Go ahead. I'm ready. Jesus told him to go ahead. And as he got up from the table, notice he went as far as the foot washing, but he didn't go as far as taking the Last Supper. He went as far as the foot washing. And Judas Iscariot went up, and he went out to betray Jesus and sold him out for 30 pieces of silver, 30 pieces. The price, hallelujah, of a slave. And he sold Jesus out. He went up there and got him out. And Jesus, he begins to tell them that my soul is troubled. My soul is troubled because my hour has come. My hour has come. My soul is troubled. And I got to go. I got to go. I got to give up my life. I got to give my life as a ransom. I got to die for those that are here. And that brings us to St. John chapter number 1. And as Jesus begins to talk to them, he begins to say, let not your heart be troubled, because there's going to be a change taking place. That if I don't go, I can't send back another comforter to help you. If I don't go, I can't finish my mission. I can't finish the goal that God has sent me. If I don't make this change, then everything will remain the same. So he begins to tell them, let not your heart be troubled. You see, the Bible tells us that we don't like change and we don't like trouble. The scripture says that a man that is born of a woman is of a few days and full of trouble. There's trouble on every hand. Don't we have trouble? Thank you, Lord. Trouble on every hand. Even when a baby is born, I believe the baby goes through a traumatic experience coming through through the matrix just to get birth into this world. And if the baby's not crying right, then they spank them on the behind or rub them on their feet just to get them to make some noise. And I believe that even when things are being birthed in the new, we continue to have trouble. There's some travailing that needs to take place. There's a process that needs to take place. And we all have to go through various processes in life. If you live your life, the Bible says, trying to avoid trouble. The scripture says that if you're faith in adversity, your strength is small. So we ought to get used to trouble. If we shirk in the face of adversity, our strength is small. We should never have it in our minds to avoid a certain amount of trouble. Now, if a car was headed your way, a Mack truck was headed your way, I don't expect you to stand in the street and dare the truck to hit you. That'd be foolish, all right? Hallelujah. So God ain't asking you to avoid that kind of trouble. But what God is saying in your mind, the troubles of life, the situations that we must face in life, God does not want us to avoid them. And you know, we have a way of avoiding sometimes. That we'll rather sit back and allow things to happen and not really take control of our lives. How many, my God, I feel like talking to you today. How many of you know God wants you to take control of your life? Oh God, the enemy wants to kill, steal, and to destroy. But God says, I want you to have life and that more abundantly. And God knows that you need help with your life. That's why he sends you a comforter. That's why he sends you the Holy Ghost to help you. It literally walks beside you to aid you in your lifestyle. It aids you to lead you and guide you into all truth. So that's why he said, let not your heart be troubled. You know, God has a plan. Tell your neighbor, God has a plan. God has a plan. And when Jesus said that, told his disciples, let not your heart be troubled, he was telling them that because he had a plan. That he knew where he was going. He knew that he was giving up his life. He knew that the Father had put all things into his power. He knew that when he died on that cross, that he was going to get up in 3 days. And he knew that when he got up in 3 days, he was going to have all power. So, oh my God, he knew. He knew about the plan. And he wanted them to trust in the plan. Yeah. You know, a lot of times when we have trouble with Jesus and we have trouble in life, we don't trust in the plan. We try to make up our own plan instead of trusting in the plan that was already designed for us before the foundation of the world. And when we trust in God's plan, when we put our hopes in God's plan, not just some things, but everything, is going to turn out right because God is the master plan. How many know God has a master plan? He has a master plan for your life. That's why Jesus said that you are my disciples, and I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. And he said, let not your heart be troubled. He said, if you believe in God, believe also in me. You know, brothers and sisters, if you're not going to have a troubled heart, you've got to have faith in Jesus. Oh God, if you're going to deal with a troubled heart and overcome a troubled heart, you've got to walk by faith and not by sight. You've got to walk by faith knowing that God has your back. Walk by faith knowing that God has a plan. And with God's plan, the scripture tells us, my God, that faith is that substance of things hoped for. And it's the evidence of things not seen. And what gets us agitated, what gets us in trouble because we can't see what God is about to do. But how many of you know you've got to walk by faith and not
my sight. It's not about what I can see. It's about what I believe. It's about who I believe. And it's about who I got my trust in. Now, my God, the closer and the more you walk with Jesus, the more you'll be able to trust Him. The more you lean on Jesus, the more you'll be able to put your hope in Him. The Bible tells us that our Lord and our Savior, which is Jesus Christ, that He can be touched. How many of you know He can be touched? He can be touched with the feelings of your infirmities. The apostles that Jesus was having His meal with, they didn't tell Jesus that our hearts are troubled, that our hearts are weak. You know, you ain't got to tell Jesus that your heart is troubled, that your heart is weak. Because Jesus, He can be touched. He can be touched with the feelings of your weakness. He can be touched with the feelings of your infirmities. In other words, He knows when you are in trouble. He knows what you are feeling. Not only does He know, but He knows how to deliver you. He knows how to set you free, because He Himself was tempted, the Bible says, in all points. But hallelujah, but just like you are, but yet without sin. He knows. Tell somebody, He knows. He knows about your struggles. He knows how the enemy is trying to destroy you. Oh, He told Peter, He said, Simon Peter, the devil has desired to sift thee as wheat. But Jesus told him, He said, Simon, I pray for you that your faith fail not. I prayed. You see, Jesus, He's that great high priest. He knows how to pray for us in our time of trouble. He knows how to pray for us even at our weakest hour. You see, the devil has always wanted to kill, steal, and to destroy. Oh, but Jesus, the Bible says, Jesus, somebody say Jesus. You see, Jesus knows all about your struggles. Jesus knows how to set the captive free. Jesus is anointed. He's anointed to deliver you. He's anointed to bring you out. He's anointed to help you. But in order to allow your mind not to be troubled, you've got to have faith and confidence in Jesus. The Bible says that faith cometh by hearing, and that by the word of God. And Jesus, the Bible says, is that word. He's that word that was made flesh, and He dwelt among us. The Bible says that we beheld His glory, the glory of the only begotten of the Father. He's full of grace. Oh, when you trust Jesus and you tap into Him by faith, you're tapping into His grace. The Bible says that the grace of God has appeared unto all men. As Jesus, the strength of God, the deliverance of God, the power of God, the ability to get you through whatever you're going through. You see, with a troubled heart, when you have trouble in your mind, that's a symptom of a lack of faith. Oh God, let me help you here, brothers and sisters. It's all right to have trouble. Oh, but you should not allow that trouble to consume your life. You should not allow trouble to stop you from moving forward, to stop you from walking in the change that God has desired of you. Even Jesus said, my soul is troubled. But notice His words of faith. He said, for this cause came I into the world. He said, Father, though my soul is troubled, glorify me with the glory that I had with me himself, but he had faith in the plan of God. You can't have faith in yourself, but you've got to have faith in the plan of God. There's a lot of trouble that should come your way, because trouble is common to every man, to every boy, to every woman, to every little girl. Should not destroy you. That trouble should get you to refocus upon Jesus. That trouble should get you to lay aside every weight, every sin that so easily besets you, and get your mind on the bridge that is able to take you over those troubled waters. Oh God, I want you to hear me today, that if you're dealing with trouble, if you're dealing with anxiety, if you're dealing with fear, that's a natural thing. But God has a solution, and his name is Jesus. Oh God, Jesus is the answer. Jesus is the way. Jesus is the hope. Jesus is the problem solver. Oh God, when the children of Israel, when they were going over, my God, when they were going over unto the promised land, when they needed some help, they trusted God. They trusted God's plan. Oh God, he told Moses, I want you to stretch out your rod. And then he stretched out his rod. He put his trust in the plan of God. The enemy on the one side, the sea on the other side. Oh God, and mountains surrounding them. But they didn't know that God had a plan. They feared that the enemy was going to destroy them. But God had already made a way of escape. God told them, stretch out your rod. And when they followed God's plan, God opened up the Red Sea. And they walked on that water. They walked on that land, on dry land. And they stopped in the middle of it, and they worshiped their God. You know, when you're getting ready to make a transition, you should stop in the middle of it and worship your God. You better stop and give your God a praise. You better stop and give your God some glory, because he woke you up this morning and he started you on your way. You ought to say, Lord, in the midst of my trouble, I will bless you. In the midst of my struggle, I will give you glory. I will give you honor. And I will give you praise. Oh God, brothers and sisters, sisters and brothers, you've got to realize that when you're walking with Jesus, that Jesus has a plan. That's why he told his disciples, he said, let not your heart be troubled, and neither allow it to be afraid. He told them that in my Father's house there are many mansions, and if it were not so, I would have told you. He said, I go away to prepare a place for you, that where I am, there you may be also. I want to stop and tell you that God has a plan for your life. I want to stop and tell you that though you may not see it, though you may not understand it, but if you put your trust in Jesus, it shall come to pass. If you put your trust in Jesus, he shall make a way. If you put your trust in Jesus, not just some things, but everything, it's going to be all right. Somebody say, be all right. It's going to be all right. When I wake up in the morning, oh Lord, my eyes may be heavy. I may not know what I'm going to be facing. But what I do know, I got the Lord on my side. When you wake up in the morning, you may not know what you're facing, but what you should know, that you got the Lord on your side. And if God be for you, who the heck can be against you? You see, God, he wants to show himself strong and mighty in all of your trouble. It can be addiction. He wants to show himself strong. It can be financial problems. He wants to show himself strong. It can be backfiring. He wants to show himself strong. It can be a lack of faith. He wants to show himself strong. So it doesn't matter whatever you're facing. Let not your heart be troubled. Don't get agitated. Don't get moved by what you see. Just get a little talk. Just have a little talk. Just have a little talk. Just have a little talk with Jesus. And not just some things, but everything is gonna be alright. Somebody say, alright, it's gonna be alright. I came to Jesus just as I was. I was wounded. I was worn. I was sad. But I found in him a resting place, and he has made me glad. How do you know if you just come to Jesus? Just come to the little yellow valley, just come to the brighter morning star, just come to the rose of Sharon, and he can turn it. He can turn your sorrow around. He can turn your pain around. He can turn your problem around. Go on and clap your hands and give the Lord a praise. Jesus said, and I'm God. He has a plan. He said, don't let your heart be troubled. Because I got a plan. When I know, I'm going to send you a comfort. He said, hallelujah. I'm going to send you something that can help you. He said, you shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost has come upon you. He said, I got a plan. I'm going to send you somebody that's going to walk alongside you, that's going to lead you and guide you, that's going to give you grace and strength. It's going to help you in your time of trouble. Something about this Holy Ghost. I said, there's something about this Holy Ghost that I cannot explain. But I got it. I got it. And you know, I'm going to be honest with you. You take everything I got, but don't take the Holy Ghost. Amen? And I'll bargain with you. Frank, I got a gun on you. Give me all your clothes. You can have it. Give me all your money. You can have it. Give me the Holy Ghost. Can't have it. You might as well kill me. Because I trust you. Because if you kill me, that spirit that dwell in me is your what? Pricking my mortal body and raise me from the dead. I got the plan. Do you got the plan? That if any man be in Christ, he's a new creature. All things have passed away. Behold, all things have become new. It says, don't allow your heart to be troubled in sudden calamity. Because when sudden trouble comes, you turn your face to the Lord. When certain trouble hits, you trust in God's plan that
works together for the good.
Yes, it does.
Amen? If I never experienced trouble, I would have never gotten saved. If you never experienced trouble, you would have never called on the Lord. When people are doing good, they don't call on Jesus. But I'm doing good. I got to remind myself to call on Jesus. When you're doing good, you got to remind yourself to call on Jesus. That's why the Lord said, when you get in the houses you didn't build, don't forget about your God. Don't forget about your God. Hallelujah. Trouble, that's a way of bringing you closer. Trouble, that's a way of getting you to see Him. When King Uzziah died, the prophet, he saw the Lord and he was high and lifted up. Some things got to die in your life. Sometimes you got to let stuff go so that you can be able to see the Lord and see Him high and see Him lifted up. Trouble. Let not be for my affliction. Trouble. If it had not been for my problem. Trouble. If it had not been for the enemy attacking me. Trouble. If I would have shut out of my son, I would have known the Lord. I would have known Him in the heart of my sin. I would have known that He is power and that He is mine. Lord, only in your power. And Lord, we believe that Father, we thank you and we praise you. Bless each and every soul that is here on today. Sanctify us holy. Keep us in the center of your will. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. May the Lord watch between me and thee while we're absent. Hey, one for another. This we pray in Jesus' name. Amen.